Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we are going to take a first look at the brand new Threads app. Threads is a social networking app made by Meta, also the maker of Instagram and Facebook. With Threads, you can view a feed of everything that's going on with your friends or people you may be interested in. You can also post your own messages. You could post text, photos, and also videos. You could also reply or even like messages. We're going to start with how you can get Threads, and then we'll look at how you can use it. Let's check this out. To get Threads, head to threads.net on your phone and then click on the button at the bottom. This brings you to the App Store or the Play Store where you can install Threads. You can also get there through the Instagram app. In the top right-hand corner, click on the hamburger menu and then click on Threads, and that will also bring you to the App Store. One caveat to call out, to be able to use Threads, you need an Instagram account. And the reason why is they share the same username and also some of the same backend infrastructure. The benefit of that is you already have an established network that will carry over onto Threads. Once you finish installing the Threads app and running through the first run experience, congratulations, you are now in Threads. The app drops you in the main home view. You can see that in the bottom left-hand corner. And this is your feed that shows you all the different content from the people you follow and also people you may be interested in. You'll see that it's made up of text, you may also have pictures, and you'll also see videos in this feed. The actions that you could take on any one of these messages is pretty typical for a social network. Right here, you could like a message. I could also reply to it, and here I could share my thoughts. You can also repost this message to all of your followers. Here you could repost or you could quote the message. And right over here, I can also share this message with others. I have a few different options down below. When you click into one of these messages here, I see the original message and I can see all the different replies to this message. Right up on top, I'll click on back. Back on the main screen, at the very bottom, I have my app navigation bar. We're currently on the home view or the feed view. But right here, let's click on this search icon. And here I can search for new accounts to follow. At the very top, I could type in an account name if I already have someone in mind. Or down below, I can also browse various accounts to see if any of these might be interesting. Now let's follow Kourtney Kardashian. I think that sounds interesting. Let's click on follow, and then let's click into this account. And this drops me into Kourtney's profile, and right up on top, I can see all of her profile information. If we look down just a little bit here, I can see threads and also replies. The threads view contains all of the different threads that she's initiated or reposted. It looks like there's some interesting content here. Right up on top, I can also click into replies, and this includes messages or threads that others have started that she replied to. Here we see a message from Chloe, and it looks like Kourtney posted a wave. Interesting. This content seems somewhat engaging and compelling. To make sure I never miss any of these updates, here I could click on this bell icon, and that way I'll be notified every time she posted. Or if I want to dig deeper, I could even jump into her Instagram. Now, I'm not quite sure if this content aligns with my interests, so right here I could tap here and I'll unfollow her account. I think I'd like to write a post now. Down at the very bottom navigation bar, let's click on this compose icon. This now drops me into a view where I can compose my very own thread. I can write up to 500 characters of text, or I can include up to 5 minutes of video. Let me type in some text. I've now typed in my very first thread. Right here, you'll see a paperclip icon, and when I click on this, I can include photos or videos as part of my thread. I'll select this one of this handsome guy making cookies, and then click on add. This has now added the photo to my thread. I think that looks good. Right down here, I can click on this text, and I can define who can reply to my thread. Currently, it's set to anyone, but you can also limit who can reply. I'll click out of that, and in the bottom right-hand corner, I'll click on post. Now that I've posted my very first thread, down on the bottom navigation, let's click on the profile icon. And here I can see my profile. And look at that. Here's my very first thread. Here it shows up. And this is a pretty quality post. Down below, I'll click on the like icon. Similar to what we saw with Kourtney, here I could also see all of my replies. And it looks like Janet was looking for an explanation of threads. You ask, I deliver. Within the profile view, not only can I see my threads and also replies, but up on top, I can edit my profile. When I click on that, here I could edit my bio and also my link. Here, I could even turn my profile private. Now up on top, you'll see my account name has a lock symbol next to it. That's because you have to go through the Instagram app to be able to change your account name. Up on top, let's click on done. Back on my main profile page, in the top left-hand corner, you can click on this globe icon, and this exposes all of the different privacy settings. Right up here, I'll click on back. In the top right-hand corner, you can click on the Instagram icon, and that'll bring you to the associated Instagram account. And in the top right, if you click on this icon, this brings you to all of your different settings. One of the notable settings here, you can click into notifications, so you can define when you should be notified about activity. Let's click on back. As more and more people start joining threads, it'll become livelier and there'll be more activity going on. You'll have people like your different threads, you'll have people replying to you. To keep track of all of that activity, at the very bottom navigation bar, let's click on the heart icon, and this opens up the activity view. Here you can see a summary of all of the activity going on. Right next to that, you can also filter the view. Here you could just see replies, you could also look just at all of the mentions, or you could also view when verified users have reached out to you. Now over here, I'll click on all and I'll look through some of my activity. All right, well that was a first look at the new Threads app. Let me know what you think down below in the comments. Do you see yourself using this app moving forward? At least for me personally, it seems like a really solid app, although it is missing some key functionality. For example, you can't have nested replies, and you also can't yet send direct messages. But I'm sure that with time, those features will come. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.